This is Dr. Chappuis from Spine Center Atlanta. Hope everyone's doing well today. I'm here to talk to you about lumbar fusions or spinal fusion. Once you have a situation where a fusion's needed, it can be done from the back, which is called a posterior instrumented lumbar fusion, TLIF or transforaminal lumbar interbody fusion. It can be done from the side, which is known as an XLIF or lateral fusion, or it can be done through your stomach, which is called an anterior lumbar interbody fusion. I'm here today to talk about the anterior procedure because I think over my 30 years of practice, it has the best overall outcome at one or two levels. And this is done in conjunction with a general access surgeon. It's done through a vertical incision just to the left side of your belly button. The general surgeon then gets us down to the front of the spine. With the microscope, then we remove the disc that's herniated, any spurs that are pushing on the spinal cord. And then we put an interbody fusion device. And there's a number of these on the market. The one we like to use is shown here. It's called INFIX. We put bone graft, and then we use infused BMP in the cage, and we put a plate and screws over that. And that's called a standalone anterior lumbar interbody fusion. Now, some surgeons will turn you over and actually put screws from the back. Also, in our experience, at least at one level, that's not necessary, possibly at two. For sure, if three levels are done, then we feel like that's necessary. The success rate for a one-level anterior lumbar interbody fusion is really 90-some percent, and the fusion rate is close to 100% with using infused BMP, which is basically bone morphogenic protein. And this stimulates your bone cells to make bone. And so that's what causes a fusion to heal. Now, one of the problems of fusions that you'll hear people talk about is the levels above or below the fusion now are at increased risk for developing problems. But again, at one level, that's not so much of a problem. There are total disc replacements for the lumbar spine. Some surgeons are using those. We're not, because we feel the success rate with an anterior lumbar interbody fusion is as good as or better than a one level disc replacement. Plus, if the disc replacement fails, you have to go back in and re-expose the area, and there's veins and arteries and the ureters are in the way, which can cause problems. So we feel, at least today, for one level, an anterior lumbar interbody fusion is best.